Clearly, that we're debating on the resurrection. If you want to debate on the resurrection, we can do that.
Let's start from the oneness of God. No, is Jesus God?
I brought my material.
No, we go to the beginning, come back to resurrection.
I brought my...
We want to know whether God is one or two.
No, from
the beginning. That's the first, and then come back to resurrection.
Muhammad, I brought my material to debate on that. If you don't want to debate on that, I'll find someone else.
Okay. Beginning, we've got to go back.
Check out Muhammad.
We can come to the resurrection.
He wants to check it out on the resurrection.
No, we don't want the beginning. We can come to the resurrection. I want to start from the beginning. Come back.
I'll give you some evidence.
We have to go on one.
I'll give you some evidence.
One back.
Muhammad, debate this.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word. We will come back.
Listen.
John 1:4, and the Word took flesh.
Listen.
You want to talk about
that? Then you can come back. No. We have to go from the beginning.
Debate
before resurrection.
Calm down. You've had too much Weetabix, bro. If you prove that Jesus did not die and rise again, it's all over for us. This is our main thing, that Jesus died and rose again. And we have tons of evidence to prove this. Now, let's get on with the debate.
No.
What are you afraid of?
No.
What's he afraid of?
I'll give you.
You're making accusations.
No.
Let me give you some evidence.
We don't have any proof. We have it in the Quran.
Is he scared in that face?
No.
He's scared. You are scared. I can see your face.
This guy's scared. This kind of. Guess what?
Do I look scared?
Listen to me. No, you said I'm scared.
He's happy.
Listen to me.
You're scared. I'm not scared, bro.
He said I'm scared. Listen to me. Listen. I can prove to all people. Everybody sitting here. No, wait. Let me talk. You talk. Everybody here, I can prove to them that you are not a true believer of Jesus Christ. And if I'm wrong, I'll give you £300.
Listen.
You'll be scared.
You don't dictate to us.
No, you said I'm scared and you said that. Now I'm going to prove to everybody that this guy is not a believer.
No. I'm going to go on.
Wallahi, I said.
I'm
going
to give you the evidence. The evidence is there.
No, you said I'm scared.
The evidence.
No, before you go that day.
Muhammad, I'm going to give you the evidence.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ?
Just chill out. I'm going to give you the evidence.
Do you believe in Jesus first?
In 1 Corinthians chapter 15.
That's the thing.
It says this. It says, according to the scriptures, and then it says, there were eyewitnesses, Peter, and then there were other eyewitnesses, even 500. But without my Bible, I can show you evidence about Jesus Christ. The Quran, 600 years after Jesus, says that Jesus did not die and did not rise again, did not die. Now, who are you going to believe? The Quran, 600 years after, says he did not die, or are you going to believe the eyewitnesses? In 1 John chapter 1, it says we are eyewitnesses. Who are you going to believe? The eyewitnesses or the Quran that has no eyewitnesses? Muhammad, I'll finish this and then you can come in. Secondly, we have the Arabic, 4th century Arabic translation of Josephus, and in there it talks about Jesus doing miracles, that he was a good man, and that he died under Pontius Pilate. We can prove that he died. We also can show that there's evidence that he rose again. You do not put evidence in that incriminates you, right? There's incriminating evidence in the Gospels that if you were lying, you would not put in. Women were not valued in the ancient world. They were not valued. They, one woman was worth two men. Who were the first people that saw Jesus rise again?
Women.
It was the women. So let me recap and then you come in, Muhammad. Number one, we have eyewitnesses. The Quran doesn't have eyewitnesses. Number two, we have external evidence, Josephus, the Arabic translation. Number three, we have incriminating evidence against the Gospels. The fact that they put it in shows that they're not lying, that they're telling the truth. There is no evidence whatsoever that he can provide, that the Quran can provide any evidence, or he can provide any evidence that Jesus did not die and rise again. Let's listen to what he has to say. Go, Muhammad.
Look, when I came here, I was there. You told me, you want to debate Muhammad? You were having an argument about the case of Zakaria. I said, come here. Now you choose a topic. Resurrection, let's go back to the beginning. Any Muslim? No, let me finish talking. Let me talk. I'm going to quote extensive from the Bible today. We're going to be here 2 hours. And I'm going to show everybody this guy is not a believer of Jesus Christ. He passed the test 300 pounds. He said, I'll give you 300 pounds today. I'm going to prove everybody here.
You said, let's debate.
My brother and sister, he's not a believer.
He does not.
And he's going to be shocked.
Muslims, let me explain to you. Muslims, I love you dearly. Let me explain to you how debates go. Let me explain. Let me explain to you how debates go. We have a topic and we debate that topic. The topic is the resurrection.
We'll come to that.
If you go on to the one that you've got,
I've got three hours. Muhammad, I'll go from the beginning, walk you up the resurrection. If you I love go, it. Just from the beginning.
You've had too much Weetabix, bro. Calm down.
Yes.
Listen. Do you want to debate or do you want to debate? Do you want to debate?
Yes, on the resurrection. On the resurrection.
I say that. Look, I'll start from the beginning. Let me finish talk.
I gave you your chance. Mohammed, my dear. Just calm down. Listen, I give the evidence. Now you debunk it. If you don't debunk it, we'll get somebody else to do it.
Yes.
Come on down.
I
just want to tell you something. In Britain, we believe in free speech. So I'll let him speak in a minute. Islamic countries don't believe in free speech. We believe in free speech.
Half an hour. I'll prove everything. From the beginning to the end.
Mohammed, just chill.
I'll chill. Half an hour.
Let's start. Right. I gave him some arguments about Jesus dying and rising again. If he does not stick to that topic, I will butt in. Now it's over to you. If you butt in,
are you scared?
If you change the topic, I will step in. Now go.
Let me have a cup of day with you.
Now he's flustering. Now he's like a Christian speaking in tongues. can talk now. now they've got to deliberate now. Are you Shia or are you Sunni? Let us know when you've decided. Because the Shia, believe that Quran's been corrupted, by the way. But
One second.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My dear brothers in Islam and non-Muslims alike. If the Prophet wants to debate me, it will be a different matter totally on intellect. Just to let you know before we even get on camera.
No, he doesn't. Okay? Are you saying you're superior?
Okay?
To...
No, I'm not saying I'm superior. Because there's certain people, you can't come out here, start saying verses of Quran, and you're not a scholar or a teacher of Islam. This is called illiterate behavior. Okay? So please do not come and talk Quran. Yeah, you can't come out and talk.
Can I just say,
if he wants to debate, whatever he wants to debate, it doesn't matter what he wants to talk about.
Can I just come in? Guys,
I read the Bible.
He moaned that I wasn't letting him speak. I gave him a chance. Mohammed, finish now. I gave him a chance. Mohammed, don't attack me as a person.
Look. I ask you.
Stick to the argument. We gave solid evidence for the resurrection.
I came here. You called me to debate. You chose a crucifixion. I said I'm going to start from the beginning.
What we've seen by the Muslim community in Hyde Park is they're unable intellectually to engage because they don't have the scholarship.
You're unable to listen.
So
you're attacking me as well now. You're saying community.
Let me talk.
I'll let you talk in a second and then I'll finish. What we've seen here, I gave him a chance and they had the Council of the Nine Arab countries there. They were counseling each other. They didn't know what to say. You know, if I give him another chance, they'll have another council meeting. Right? He's got his chance. I'll give him one more chance.
Wait. You said that John 1:1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. In the beginning. 1:14, and the Word took on flesh and dwelt among us. Yeah? What is the purpose of Jesus coming to the world?
We are atoning sacrifice.
Listen to me. Hold on. You said Jesus is God incarnate. Listen to me, woman. God incarnate.
Yeah.
He is Jesus and the God are one. We have to go to the Trinity. The concept of Trinity is in the first epistle of John 5:7. Yeah? For the three that bear recording heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost. And these three are one. We're going to go back. We said that Jesus is the God. Not the same. Jesus cannot be God. That if said Jesus died on the cross, do you mean that God died?
Okay, right.
Yeah, that's good, yeah.
Right, my esteemed brother here, rather than deal with the resurrection, he's going on a different topic. But let me answer. On the issue of the Trinity, 1 times 1 times 1 is what? One times one times one times one is one. So you can have 3 and 1, right?
Yeah.
On the issue of dying, right, it says in 1 Timothy 3:16, great is the mystery of God. Godliness, that God was manifested in the flesh. It is a mystery. It is beyond you. But you have a problem. The Quran is eternal. It came down from eternity and it became paper. And then Uthman burnt the paper. Does that mean the Quran's been destroyed? Eternal Quran comes down to be paper. Paper destroyed. Does that destroy the Quran? Wait a minute. We believe Jesus is the eternal word and he died. You believe the eternal Quran and the Quran was... But let me finish. You're interrupting now. Let's get back to the topic in hand, which is the death and resurrection of Jesus, right? I gave him cutting-edge scholarship on Josephus, the Arabic translation. There is actually stronger evidence for my case. Most of the manuscripts of Josephus actually have that he died and rose again.
What is the
right?
Evidence?
Wait a minute. Let me finish. Is he interrupting?
Yeah.
But I weakened myself by choosing one manuscript because the majority of manuscripts have he died and rose again. But I chose Josephus, the Arabic one, which is in the 4th century, which still backs up my case. So I'm trying to help you. Now we have Tacitus. Tacitus says that Jesus died under Pontius Pilate, which is round about 110 AD. Now Tacitus clearly states that if he's using documents, right, from Rome. And when he's not using documents or he's not sure, he makes it clear, I'm not sure. But when he says Jesus died under Pontius Pilate, he doesn't say, I'm not sure. That means Tacitus had documents that he used in Rome about Jesus. Now, he's not engaged with any of this historical scholarship.
Let me finish and then I'll get it.
In Surah 2, verse 1, it says the Quran is a guidance and light. If that's true, according to him, he is not looking at history from objective historical studies. He is looking at history from his biased Quranic looking at it. I'm looking at it not just from my Bible. I'm looking at it the way secular historians look at it. I'm much more objective than my very passionate friend here, who seems to have had a lot of Weetabix today. So over to you, Mohammed. God bless you, brother, and you're a lovely guy, and it's great to meet you.
Look, you are talking, clap. You can't show any evidence. You're just talking. In fact, when Jesus was crucified, why were his disciples? The disciples of Jesus, what are they? Gospel of Mark chapter 14, verse 15. Talk. Mark 14, 15. When Jesus, no. You read the Bible, it's your Bible.
You go.
When Jesus being crucified,
it's over to you.
Gospel of Mark chapter 14, verse number 15. Why were his disciples?
Yeah, they
Wait, tell me, what are they?
No, I want to be fair and give you the chance to talk.
No, answer the phone. Why are they?
Let me finish. You talk, and then I'll talk.
Well, I'm asking, why are they?
I will tell you in a second.
I'm sorry.
I'll answer in a minute.
Okay, according to the Bible, all the disciples, they forsake and they fled. They all fled. Why? If Jesus had told them that God sent into this world to die on this cross for our sins, why would they run? Jesus didn't know he was going to die. According to the Bible, Jesus did not know he was going to die. Gospel of Mark, chapter 27, verse 46. According to the Bible, what Jesus been crucified? Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani? Oh my God, why hast thou forsaken me? Why did he know?
Okay, keep going on.
You said that Jesus knew he was going to die. God sent him into this world to die on the cross for our sins. Because of the sin of Adam and Eve. Sin entered into the world. And because of that, God sent him to die. Why did he communicate to his disciples? If he had communicated to his disciples, they would have fled him. They all ran. They forsook him. And he did not know that he was going to die. Why was he blaming God? Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani? Oh my God. Why have you forsaken me? Why?
Now because he's stuck to the topic, I let him speak as much as he wanted.
Look.
Okay.
Answer my question.
Let me answer, yeah. He actually is quoting Psalm 22.
I didn't quote Psalm 22. Gospel of Mark. First of all, Mark.
Listen. Jesus, the Lord Jesus is quoting Psalm 22, sir. Okay? So that answers that. Why did they run away? They ran away, but they came back. If you read the text, if you go on, they came back. Now, listen. They did not expect a Messiah. Listen, Muhammad, because they were expecting, the Jews were expecting.
Let me. They quoted, they came back. Quote the verse so they can check it. No, but it's insincere.
You're attacking me as a person.
You're attacking him when you say he had too much Wheatabix.
Answer it.
What he's doing here is personal attack.
You attacking? You said he had too much Wheatabix.
He's sweating now.
So you're trying to say he's too fat?
What are you trying to do?
Why did Jesus? Why did the disciples fled? If you had told them that he was going to die on the cross,
let me finish.
If they knew he was going to die, why did they forsake him?
Let me finish.
Don't digress.
What they do in debate tactics when they do this is trying to put you off the scent, right? Off the topic, right?
You're just defending yourself.
Let me finish. I didn't attack him.
Don't talk. No, you not.
Listen.
You told him to shut up. It's on video.
He's sweating. Now go.
Let me finish. First of all, he said, why did Jesus say, my God, he's quoting Psalm 22. Secondly, the disciples did not just run away, they came back. If you read later on in the Gospels, you'll find that they came back. You just read them.
Show me.
Right? Wait a minute, let me finish. Thirdly, Dominic Crossan is one of the world's authorities. He's a person who is a skeptic. He doesn't believe what I believe. He doesn't believe what Christianity believes. He said that Jesus dying on the cross is one of the most well-attested facts in ancient history. Bart Ehrman, who the Muslims quote here to attack the Bible, believes Jesus died on the cross. Dale Allison, one of the greatest scholars on this topic, who's not a Christian, doesn't believe what I believe, says this. that the disciples believed in a resurrection, right? Also, N.T. Wright wrote a book, Jesus and the Jesus and the Son of God. It's one of the greatest books that has been written on this topic. And he looked at the history of Judaism, and he looked at the Jews only believed in a resurrection. So when the disciples said that Jesus rose, it was not a vision, that only Jews believed in a physical resurrection. Now, I've given him loads of scholarly data.
No evidence. From the Bible.
Prove the Bible is reliable. Even Jesus. No answer. This guy is also insincere here.
Before I hear from the Bible, I want to know it's a reliable source.
He's not prepared to come here. What the Muslims do is they memorize a few verses that they can attack the Christian. You're the one who quoted more from the Bible than he has. You're the one contradicting yourself.
Let
me just finish.
Let me just finish.
I've given you historical evidence, Josephus and Titus. I've given you top scores.
I'm going to give you the Bible. And we've not proof. Okay,
in Luke chapter 1, it says, "For as much as many have taken in hand to set forth in order a declaration of those things, which even has delivered them unto us, which from the beginning were eyewitnesses and ministers of the word, it seemed good to me also, having had perfect understanding of these things from the very first, to write unto thee in order, most excellent Theophilus, thou might know with certainty those things wherein thou hast been instructed." The Greek word for eyewitnesses is the same Greek word that Polybius used. Polybius was a 2nd century historian, a 2nd century Greek historian. And he believed that if you're going to write history, you must use eyewitness material. And Luke is using the same Greek word. Excuse me.
No, you're talking. Let me talk now. I'll give you 5 minutes.
Baba, you've been speaking for a while.
Now listen, we are not moderator.
This is a very scholarly important thing.
Okay, let's give him one more minute.
Let me finish. He doesn't know the Bible. I'm telling you.
Let me finish. Give him one more minute.
Luke says eyewitnesses. It's the same word that Polybius used in the 2nd century BC. He said, Polybius, that you must use eyewitness material. Luke is using that Greek word. The Gospels in modern scholarship today are seen as historical biography. The modern scholars have come to that conclusion by looking at how they wrote biographies in the ancient world. Luke and the Gospels are writing from eyewitnesses. Right? That is the scholarly opinion today. Check out Richard Baucom, Jesus and the Eyewitnesses, if you're going to engage in the scholarship.
Look, I just tell you.
Now, Muhammad son,
I quote it for you. Yeah? Yes. Gospel of Matthew, chapter 27, 46. Jesus cried to God, "Oh my God, oh my God, why have you forsaken me?" I'm asking you, did Jesus know they were going to die? Answer it. Did he know that he was going to be crucified?
Muhammad, don't shout.
No, answer me. If he knew who was God, why are you blaming God? Why have you forsaken me? This is incredible.
I told you,
Gospel of Mark 14:50, the disciples fled and forsook him. And Jesus also cried to God to save him from the cross. Do you know that?
And Muhammad.
Hold on. You know Jesus cried on the cross. Do you know that?
I'm going to come save you.
Just go. If Jesus is God, how's he dying? How's he not know he's going to die?
Contradiction. So, Jesus, in the days of
you guys are contradicting yourself and you're not aware.
With loud voice, to whom he was able to save him from death.
Can I finish?
And he was hard for his God to fear. The Bible said that Jesus cried to God to save him from death. And he was hard for his
If Jesus is God, why is he crying?
Okay, can I finish?
In the book of Hebrews. In the book of Hebrews.
Contradiction.
Can I finish? I've heard what you said.
No, let me finish talking. You talk about 5 minutes. Let me finish.
Go on.
You're stopping.
No, if you want, I can give you half an hour. So look at it. My brother, we are telling you Jesus, peace not him, was the Messiah, was the prophet sent to the Jews. He's not God. Trinity is a fabrication. See, all your beliefs here. Here, you see this book here? 1 John 5:7, "For there are three that bear record in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost, and these three are one." You see, I took it out here. Scholars, Christian scholars, your Bible they call it not reliable. I can show you. 120 contradictions in your Bible. I can show you. Quote of now. Okay. If you have time, I've got 3 hours here. We got one topic. So we are telling Jesus was the prophet and Messiah. Said to the Jews, he never said he's God. He never said he was a man. Now Jesus coming and dying on the cross. Where did that come from? Okay. It comes from what? From a concept of when he said Adam and Eve sinned. Because of the sin, sin entered into the world. And because of that, God sent Jesus to die on the cross. For us, whose concept is that? Paul! This is Paul's concept. We said you are following Paul. You are not following Jesus. Jesus was a Muslim. Gospel of John, chapter 5, verse number 30, what he said? The Bible
is finished. It says this, it says in Isaiah 53, it says, but he was wounded for our transgressions, he was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray, and we have turned every one to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. When Christ was dying on that cross, he was dying for every thief, every murderer, anybody who's done any sin, that he was crushed. So you and I don't have any idea the wrath that came upon Jesus Christ. But when he said, my God, why have you forsaken me? He's quoting Psalm 22, which is showing that he's fulfilling the Old Testament, right? Secondly, I'm getting a bit tired now, Muhammad.
Let me finish.
Let me finish. You attack the Bible's integrity concerning textual criticism. You've got various books here, right? Number one, if you read Dr. Small's book on the Quranic textual criticism, there are textual variants within the Quran, right?
Bring it.
If you read his book on Surah 14, yeah. On Surah 14, so I've given you a reference, go find his book, Dr. Small. It's recently come out a few years ago. Go on Google Books, and there, he's very fair with the Muslims. He's very, very fair scholar. And what he says in that book, he says that early on, there was a great variety in the Quranic text. It wasn't one standard text, but soon it was standardized. In other words, somebody doctored it. So you have a controlled text. You have a kind of mafioso political manipulation going on. You have this guy, Uthman, who's the top dog, and he creates a Quranic text and manipulates it. But the scholar, Dr. Small, says we can find behind that that there were many different Qurans. There were a number of different Qurans. If I'm not telling the truth, why was it that Uthman burnt the Quranic text? But let's get back to the resurrection. In 1924, the Egyptian government made a standardized Quran. They got it wrong, and they had a ship full of Qurans.
No evidence.
And they sunk that ship.
No evidence. I want my evidence here. No evidence. No evidence here. Google. No evidence.
Hide the evidence.
I got my evidence.
No, I've given him the Bible.
This guy is insincere.
Tacitus and Josephus.
Insincere.
I've given him Donnie. Grossenbach, Del Allison.
With no evidence.
This guy.
With no evidence.
He's a street fighter apologist.
With no evidence.
Yes.
He's a street fighter apologist.
I've got £300.
Biased by Surah 2.
I'm going to show everybody now. This guy is not a believer.
Surah 2:1.
No.
I am a scholar.
I'm going to show he's not a believer.
I'm bringing scholarship to the table. He's just bringing street fighter apologist.
Give it time. Let everyone hold this.
You've got the last one. That's it.
Don't run. Are you a believer in Jesus?
He's running now.
£300. He's running.
No, he's running.
Don't run.
Why are you running?
£300 for the test. He knows I'm going to run. No, the test.
God bless.
The test. He's not a believer. £300 here. And so everybody in the past is not a believer. Are you a believer? Are you a believer? I'm asking you. Jesus is saying if you're a believer, you can do anything.
Yes.
If you're a believer, you can do anything. No. Hold on.
Get out of here.
about.
Don't run.
But he's running.
It's a simple test.
I'm gonna have a break.
You're gonna have a break.
When
you finish, I'll test you. It's a single test. Are you gonna have a break? Cross front of John.
We have a bite. Come back.
I'm gonna test you. Don't go away. You're gonna test it.
Come on.
Don't come here. I'm coming.